Dr. Our my dear colleague Shri Ashwani Chaubeji in the Health Ministry, my dear colleague ministers Dr. C. Vijay Bhaskar Reddy from Tamil Nadu and also Rajesh Topeji from Maharashtra, who I understand are part of the program, maybe others are also there, all the distinguished senior officers, secretaries, those organizing ROTO and SOTO activities in the states and in our regions, and of course our NOTO senior people here, Dr. Pramila Gupta, Dr. V.C. Agrawal and their colleagues, all the persons who have been awarded today, the organizations who have been awarded today, I have to compliment all of you, thank you, and convey my heartiest, heartfelt felicitations from the deepest core of my heart for the great work that you have been doing, and especially for the families of the people who were instrumental in making this organ donation a movement in the country. It was an emotional moment to see these names of people, diseased persons, who donated liver and heart and kidneys and lungs, etc., etc., to those. And I was reminded of a similar function that we had organized in the at the All India Institute of Medical Sciences last year. It was such a touching scene at that function, where we had both sets of families. Families whose members had donated because they got some accident, they had some suffering, they had a brain dead individual in the family, but they donated all the organs to others. And they were then the families of those who were recipients and the recipients themselves. And it was such a touching scene at the campus of All India Institute of Medical Sciences in the auditorium, when the family members could actually see, and they were seeing their own children and their own family members in the bodies of others, and they were like I think it's beyond description to describe the emotions of that particular event. Today, unfortunately, because of COVID, I have not been able to see all of you physically, but I can imagine, you see, we have no words to express our respects for the family members. Those who, I think, did their best, they dedicated their life for the country, and then they, after death, have also helped many. And it is, I think, a huge number. I have to particularly congratulate Tamil Nadu and Maharashtra and all our regional units also in Chandigarh, Mumbai, Chennai, Kolkata and Guwahati. And I understand we have almost a dozen states with active programs in the organ and tissue transplant area with these very dynamic organizations. Some of them have been honored, but that doesn't mean that the others have not worked well. Everybody is working so hard to make it a big movement in the country. I remember that during this COVID crisis, I had to talk to Dr. Vijay Bhaskar Reddy for the lung transplant of a doctor in the state of Karnataka, who was admitted and the lung was required. That doctor had served so many people, had saved so many lives. And he became a corona warrior, and being a corona warrior, he himself got affected by COVID, and in spite of the best treatments, the lungs could not be saved. But then came to the rescue people like Dr. Vijay Bhaskar Reddy, who helped and ensured that the lung could be made available. But these are, you see, these are, this is just the tip of the iceberg. So much is happening, so many people are contributing, so many things are into this process, whereby you see this organ transplant and tissue transplant activity growing in this country in a big way. You see, Nota was born in 2011, and I remember that in 2014, when I was Union Health Minister here, I had the privilege to visit Spain, which has the best transplant and organ donation program in the whole world. Although we have made significant strides in this field, at a humanitarian level, at a public awareness level, at the sincerity level, at the level of, you see, setting up facilities, at the government level, what are the issues that Rajesh Topeji mentioned, I think is already in the program. We are helping many of these poor patients for giving them these therapies, and also taking care of the patients who have these brainstem injuries and brain deaths, etc. And there I could see that there was so much of, you see, the key person in the whole movement is a transplant, coordinator. And this is a coordinator who can actually convince the family at that critical time, because the family is struggling with emotions. They are praying to God, and they are doing their best to ensure that they visit every religious place to see that their kith and kin, they are saved. But then how difficult it is at that time to convince the family members that we can probably not save this patient because he is already brain dead. And then, but the people have hope against hope, and they are, still have so much of faith in God. But then to convince at that moment, and there is that role of these transplant coordinators. I am happy that some of them have been honored, and I had the privilege to talk to them in Spain at that time. And when I went into the depth of this whole program, I could convince myself that they are probably the biggest, I think, key in the success of the program. And that is why, because of their involvement, the program in Spain is rated as the best in the whole world. And just to give you a feel of the whole thing, I think we have 48 transplants per million happening in Spain. As compared to that, in USA we have something like 33-34. In UK we have something like 24 per million. But as I said, we have to still go a long way. We have less than 1 per million in India, although in recent times we have become probably the third best country in the whole world in terms of having accomplished things successfully in this particular field. And there are so many people who need to be thanked today, who need to be felicitated today. Whatever has been done, it is just very, very symbolic. And hats off to these families who actually contributed to making this a big success. Preceding this program, in the morning at 10 o'clock, I was part of another program where you will be happy to know that 79,532 jawans of the CRPF, Central Reserve Police Force, in the presence of their senior officers, they had pledged and had delivered to me their pledge for donating their total body and organs for the cause of the nation. So this was, can you imagine that how much time it took for these 79,000 people to deliver that pledge? They had a function on 14th of August this year itself during COVID time, organized in collaboration with AIIMS New Delhi, in which they were like briefed about this subject in detail. And within 3 months, they created a movement of this magnitude. And today, within 3 months, they could actually, so there was the organ retrieval banking organization of AIIMS, and now we have this function happening here with NOTO and ROTO and SOTO, and with the presence, dignified presence of our ministers and my colleague minister here, all the diseased persons, families, and all those who have received. I think everybody deserves the highest applaud of the society. A couple of points, you see, there's a one point that was made by the DG of CRPF in the morning, that you may pledge, but once you pledge, you have to make sure that you keep your organs healthy, you keep your body healthy, because that is the most important thing. And this is, I think, so important to actually keep remembering. Already there is a Fit India movement in the country which encourages us to keep ourselves fit. And the another point that I wish to make at this particular moment is that while we pledge our eyes or our body or our organs or our tissues, as we know that a person, once he donates his eyes, he can actually help at least 4 persons getting back their sight. If he is a part of this movement, he can actually help at least 7-8 people by giving his heart, his lungs, his intestines, his pancreas, his liver, his kidneys, and so many things. He can donate his bones, his tissues can be used, his skin can be used for the patients who receive burns and all that. So all these, and then it's almost like 30-40 people of different variety can get benefited. And more than that, if you are you have donated your whole body, and even if the organs can't be retrieved, your whole body can be used by the medical college in the dissection for the successful, you see, training and education through dissection for the anatomy, which is, I think, that's a basic foundation for becoming a good doctor. And that's how a doctor can actually ultimately serve humanity all through his whole life. So this is a very, very pious movement. I don't consider it as only a technical or a scientific or a medical activity. I consider it as an act of God. It has the blessings of God. Whosoever, whether a doctor, whether a transplant coordinator, whether the family of the diseased, or whether the person who receives the organs or the tissues, everybody is part of this pious movement. And then the very fact that a lot of our policemen, the traffic police, and people on the roads, and those helping in logistics, creating these green corridors, the our officers in the state governments, our directors of the prestigious institutions, our surgeons, everybody is contributing his or her bit. And when it was, we just heard somebody saying that he never imagined that he could get a heart during COVID times, and the person had to return from US to India just because US was not able to provide him a heart, and he had that assurance or an imagination or the faith in God that probably if he returns to India, the God might be able to help me. And during COVID times also, this young boy could get a heart. During these COVID times, incidentally, that's just an incidence, I used to go and spend a significant amount of time when our dear leader Arun Jaitley ji was in hospital in the ICUs, and at that time I was told that there's a heart transplant going on. I have seen that nitty-gritty at the last moment from the closest of quarters, and I could spend a couple of hours inside the operation theater seeing that heart transplant happening, and could see both the aspects of the person whose heart was being delivered and whose heart was being transplanted, and the person who received. And then I visited that patient for quite some time. So I have not only from imagination, from the closest of quarters, experienced that this is probably the most pious activity. So whatever we do for this, I think it can't be compensated by anything, and we have to put our heart and soul into ensuring that this becomes a huge movement. We are on top of the whole world in terms of its success, and I am sure that with leaders like Dr. Vijay Bhaskar Reddy and all our health ministers, Rajesh Tope and many others, who will not take it like a routine activity. This must be on the top of our agenda, and I am sure that today is the best day to pledge around that. With these few words, once again, all my congratulations to all the people who have been awarded today, the states, the rotos, the sotos, the transplant coordinators, the donors, and those who received donation. I think all of us are lucky to be part of this function. Thank you so much, and keep this flag high, and I'm sure that we will be able to serve humanity in the best possible manner. Thank you so much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.